Going to be a powerful time. I just want to encourage us as we get started. I know when we come into the presence of God, He is so faithful to move. He knows our needs. He knows our circumstances. But sometimes we come into worship and we're focused on what our needs are. But as we start worship tonight, I'm saying, can we focus on giving our lives to Him, giving our worship to Him? Amen. I want to encourage us out of 1 Chronicles 16. It says, give to the Lord the glory due His name. Bring an offering and come before Him. Worship the Lord in the beauty of His holiness. Can we bring to Him tonight? Can we set aside all the things that are going on in our lives and bring Him our worship tonight? Amen. Can you just lift up your hands as we start in worship in this moment? Let's just lay everything aside. He is worthy of our praise tonight. He deserves all the glory, all the honor, all the strength. It all belongs to Him. And so, Jesus, we say You are worthy in this place. We declare Your worthiness. We exalt Your name in this place. We lift You high above everything else that's going on in our lives, God. All the circumstances, all the difficulties, we say we exalt Your name tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, let's worship.
Says auditorium on the outside of this room, but this room is a sanctuary. It's a place where God's glory can dwell, where his presence can be made known. And so we're welcoming him into his sanctuary. And you know, the amazing thing is that we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. And so we're opening ourselves up everywhere that we go and every place that we walk, that we say, God, I want to be a sanctuary where your glory can dwell. I want to be set apart. I want to be full of your spirit, alive in you. Mr. Church, I just want to encourage you now. Would you just open yourself up and say, Lord, you are welcome in my life. You are welcome to make your home within me. Let my life be a place where your glory dwells, God. Be enthroned. Take the first place in my heart, God. Nothing's hidden from you.
Whatever the cost, surrender to him tonight.
Oh, I am yours, completely yours.
Second, whenever he was exhorting during that song, to you our hearts are open, nothing here is hidden. Nothing here is hidden. May that be true of us tonight. Would you surrender even something that is hidden in your life? Would you bring it to the Lord? Would you allow him to purify you to that degree where you give him everything, every vice, everything that you thought was just your coping mechanism to deal with pain, medication, whatever it is, an addiction that nobody else knows about? Would you take that to the Lord right now? Go to that place with him and say, Lord, I'm yours completely yours. I'm completely abandoned. That means I'm not holding anything back for myself. I give you all of it, Lord, because I know that you are better, Lord. Only you can satisfy my soul. Only you can bring me that joy, that satisfaction, that wholeness, that whatever that vice is promising us. So would you just release that to him right now? Say, by an act of my will, I release this tie to you, God. I break this soul tie off of my life in the name of Jesus. By your Spirit, I am free. And whom the Son sets free is free indeed. You don't have to be this way anymore. You can be totally free. You are a son of God, a daughter of the Most High God, and it is His will that you are free tonight. So would you just release that, whatever that is, just go to that place. He's not intimidated by the level of sin that you've been involved with, and He will purify you white as snow with the precious blood of Jesus. So right now, we just declare that, Lord, the blood of Jesus over these people, the blood of Jesus over your sons and over your daughters, Lord. Would you purify your bride? Make us a spotless bride, Lord, that's worthy to be called yours. Lord, may we be so consumed with the love that you have shown to us, that we will forsake everything to run after you, Lord. You are so good. You're so worthy, Lord. May we burn with zeal for your house, God. May we burn with zeal and love for you, God. You did not hold anything back in showing us how much you love us, God. Far be it from us to give you a half-hearted praise. We will give you everything that we have, Lord. We are yours. We are yours. We are yours in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, we are yours. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Come on, we sing that again. Sing, I'm yours.
Oh, I am yours. Completely yours. Completely abandoned for you, Lord. Oh, I am yours. Completely yours. Completely abandoned for you, Lord. And what can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. And what can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
Come on.
Sing, what can wash away my sin?
That's the breakthrough. You feel it?
Nothing but the blood of Jesus. And what can make me whole again?
Yeah.
Oh,
there's a call tonight from the Lord asking you to resurrender. And this place right up here is an altar where he's asking you to lay it down again, or maybe even lay it down for the first time. And this altar is open. And even at your seats, wherever you are, even online, he's asking and he's calling you, come, come and give it to me again. Come and lay down your life again. And will you take that moment right now, even if it's you coming up here to this altar here at the church, or even where you're seated right now, even sitting in your seat, or just opening your arms wide right now, saying, God, I resurrender. But I feel like this is a call right now, just to resurrender, just to lay it down. And if it takes just an act of even walking up here and getting out of your seat and laying it down at the feet of Jesus, come on, he's calling. Are we gonna walk or are we gonna run? This is our answer right now. Come on, we're gonna sing. If you're calling, we're coming. We're not walking, we're running. God, we need resurrender. So we resurrender. If you're calling, we're coming. We're not walking, we're running. God, we need resurrender. Oh, so we resurrender. If you're calling, oh, we're gonna answer. We're not walking, we're running.
choose to be holy, set apart for you, my master, ready to do your will. There's no words. Our hearts just cry out. Thank you.
still in your presence. Thank you, Lord, for the gift of a still moment in your presence. Undistracted and undeterred by unfamiliarity with silence. Thank you, Lord. So many times we look for you in grand gestures, and you speak that way. But sometimes you're not in the earthquake, not in the wind, not in the fire. Sometimes you're found in a still small whisper, a voice. Because authority doesn't have to shout. And you hold all authority. Thank you, Lord, for who you are. And that true rest only comes when we understand the complete victory that you have. That you're not intimidated by what makes us fearful. Even our own doubt doesn't make you shy away. You've proven time and time again how faithful you are, Lord. And we love you. We see it now, Lord. Thank you. Let us return to stillness in our spirits and to quiet in our mind. Teach us how, Lord. Show us the ancient way, the ancient paths where the good way is, that we may walk in it. Find peace for our souls. Can we sing this old hymn that talks about trusting in Jesus? 'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take him at his word, just to upon his promise, just to know, thus saith the Lord. Jesus, 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 how I trust him, how I've proved him more and more. Jesus, oh, for grace, oh, for grace to trust him more.
Amen. Can you stay in that place and to say, Lord, we trust you. Father, we deposit and we surrender our lives to you. Father, we come into your presence and we say, you are holy. You are worthy of our praise. Father, thank you for what you did for us, which is go to the cross and die for us. Father, thank you for the exchange and the beautiful exchange of life in Christ and life in you. In Jesus' name. Yes, Jesus. Jesus. In Jesus' name. You know, in a night of worship like this, I am reminded of Jerusalem. Actually, Thursday night, they celebrate what they call Jerusalem Day, which is the day of reunification when the Jews come back to their nation and they celebrate becoming a nation and saying, this is our home, the home and the land that the Lord has given us. But it's a beautiful, beautiful image of us going up to encounter God like we did tonight, walking up to His presence. And how many of you, you know, when you go on vacation or you have different customs and things that you do, maybe when you go on a trip, you're in the car for several hours and you got songs that you like to sing, games that you like to play with your family, and things that make that moment a remembrance of something that you will carry in your heart forever. And you see, the people of Israel were no different. They celebrated and remembered what God had done to them and what God had done for them, especially. So as they celebrate the year or the day of Jerusalem, as they reunite again, they go up to the Temple Mount to see the place where they worship. And during that time for them, it's a remembrance of what they do every time they have a feast. From the Old Testament, you see them walking, and they will walk and walk and walk for days, sometimes even a week. And they look like you and I. They actually look like the choir right behind us. They would walk in the presence of God and sing songs. They will get to a pool. They will wash themselves. Isn't that amazing? This is in the Old Testament, and washing of themselves, just like we do right now in Christ Jesus, washing ourselves. And then they will start up the stairs, these beautiful long stairs, the Pilgrim Road. That's what it's called. If you haven't been there, I want you to go to YouTube and look it up. They're excavating. It's underneath the city of Jerusalem. And they're right now discovering those steps that the pilgrims would go up and encounter God up to the temple. And during that time, they would sing songs. You know, it's called the Songs of Ascent. I have fallen in love with the Songs of Ascent. There's a group actually from TKU right now over there, and some friends are attending, and they're right now in Jerusalem. And I was texting with them, and I said, you know, the Lord has put Psalm 21 in my heart for the night of worship, and they said, hey, we sang today those psalms as we went up in Jerusalem to the mountain, and we were to encounter God. And it's a beautiful remembrance of what God has done. So what I want to do today is I want to read over you Psalm 121. As you today continue to go up the mountain to encounter God, and during that time they will go up, they would pray, they would sing these songs, and then when they got up there, they would surround the temple seven times. And that might sound familiar to you, the walls coming down. Here's what they did that, and what they still do that in Jewish weddings. It's because in Jewish weddings, the bride will surround the groom seven times, so the walls of their separation will come down and they will become one in Christ. And today, as you are here and we sing this song over ourselves and to our God, God is surrounding you and dropping down those walls so you become one with Him. And so in Psalm 121, it says, I look up to the mountains. Does my help come from there? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. And then He switches and He starts talking to you and I, and He says, He will not let you stumble. The one who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, He who watches over Israel never slumbers or sleep. The Lord Himself watches over you. The Lord stands beside you as your protective shade. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon at night. The Lord keeps you from all harm and watches over your life. The Lord keeps watch over you as you come and you go, both now and forever. Amen. Amen. And as you hear this, and as you sing this, and as you worship today, I want to pray this over you. Will you close your eyes, put your hands up, and we're going to pray and say, Lord, thank you because of your presence. You will not let us stumble. You will not fall asleep or watch something else. You will watch over us. You will be watching me as I'm walking through my life. Lord, thank you for your protection. The Lord stands beside me and he's my shade. And Lord, thank you because nothing will harm me. Nothing, not day, no night, nothing will harm my family. Lord, you will keep us safe. And Lord, we are your temple. And you, Father, you come and you go with us. As we go out and as we come in, may your presence be in us today. In Jesus' name, Father, thank you for the remembrance of your presence and who you are in us. Father, thank you because you declare these things over our lives and over our families. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Can you give God a hand?
Scarred with the proof of what you chose to lose.
just lift your voice to Him.
You are so Jesus Christ.
awesome. He is good. Let's bring the band, the music, come down a minute. There's a breakthrough. There's a breakthrough that happens when we stop focusing on our problems and we start focusing on the holiness of our God. All of a sudden, the things that concern us really don't concern us anymore because He moves on our behalf and our eyes are on Him. There's a scripture in Chronicles, is it 2 Chronicles? 2 Chronicles 20:12. It says, we don't know what to do, but our eyes are on you. And so we're gonna release praise in this place with the help of Ryan Rich. So start prophesying, my man. Go for it.
Can I just say we have the most amazing choir up here tonight? The Bible says that unless we become like children, right, we will not find His presence. And these kids come up here and they remind us to be like a child in the presence of God. Amen. And tonight, we're so thankful for a choir being back. I'm so excited to see everybody back. I'm excited for the next generation that puts their hands up and praises Jesus. Amen. Amen. What A night of worship. I mean, what an encounter with God we had tonight. And can I just say, this is the beginning of your week. This is the end of your Sabbath, beginning of your week. And today, you're taking the presence of God in you, in worship. Tomorrow morning when you get in your car, put on the music and praise His name, for He is good to all of us. And He is wherever you are, wherever you go, He will be with you. Amen. Amen. And I was, during the worship time, I want to say something. There was a song where we were talking about resurrendering your life. And I know that there are some in this room that need to surrender their life to Christ. Maybe resurrender it. Maybe surrender it for the first time. And I believe today is the day that we can do that. So I'm going to call our prayer team to come forward, our pastors to come forward and stand right here in the front of the platform. And we're going to have a time where we can respond. So if you are here tonight, and tonight you encounter God, maybe for the first time, or you surrender your life to God, or maybe there's something going on in your life and you need prayer. You know, so I was talking about the Israelites going up the mountain and going to meet God. I'm reminded that they were people too. They had lives, they had kids, they had problems, they had businesses they were praying for, and in that walk, they took the time to pray and worship Him. But I'm sure like us, human like us, they had things that were in their hearts. And in that walk, they found Jesus and they found God. So today, we don't want to pass that opportunity. We want to pray for anybody that has a need. So as I'm closing, you can start coming. You can come for one of our altar members. They will be happy and they want to welcome the presence of God today with you. So come, as even as I'm closing, you will not interrupt me. You can do it at any time, and we'll stay here as long as needed. Whenever you want to come prayer, we will be here. And before we go, I want to remind you that tonight we're going to have an after party, and I'm glad you all are in summer break, because there's a lot of sugar, okay? Just saying. So we're going to have cake. It's a strawberry shortcake and lemonade, so lots of sugar. I'm glad your kids are not going to school tomorrow. And if you have kids in children's ministry, would you pick them up by 8 o'clock, or we simply just give them away, you know? I know. No, we don't. But you can bring them to the after party. It'll be right here. We want to meet you. We want to celebrate with you. We want to get to know you. So as you exit, there'll be all the food and all the sugar out there. Come and meet us there. Let's talk, let's meet, and let's celebrate together. Amen. Let me close in prayer. Father, thank you for what you did tonight. And Lord, thank you because as we end our Sabbath and enter into a week, we enter with the presence, with your presence in us, Lord, knowing that you are for us, you are not against us, and that you come and meet us wherever we are, in our cars, in our homes, as we lay down our heads in a pillow, Father, and as we get up in the morning, you are there. So, Father, we take your presence with us, in us, Father. May we be a light to the world out there of your presence in each one of us, in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Have a great night. We'll see you in the after party.